Doug Ford's appointment scandal just won't go away. Both the Liberals and the NDP are now calling for the Integrity Commissioner to investigate all of the Ford government's patronage appointments after Dean French, his former chief of staff, suddenly had to resign in disgrace. So far, the reset the premier badly needed to win back public support is failing.
It is time to bring these appointments out of Ford's back rooms and into public committees so Ontario families can finally have the answers they deserve.
The NDP are now calling on the Conservatives to recall the Standing Committee on Government Agencies for a review of all Ford government appointees, past and current. It is a scandal the government is flailing to put out, but no one seems to know if there are more skeletons. Senior government sources say they don't believe there are more questionable appointments, but they are looking into all of them. They were completely taken off guard yesterday when it was revealed another relative of Dean French's was given an appointment, a niece who promptly resigned. Ford issued this startling email to his caucus trying to do damage control. It reads in part, Dean's advice and support has been appreciated, but he no longer has any influence in this government. The problem is the premier himself set the bar for appointments when he insisted on trying to make his close friend Ron Tavener the OPP commissioner, despite intense criticism.
Premier, do you understand that this looks bad, though? The optics are terrible that you're his friend.
Cynthia, I'm your friend.
Doug Ford campaigned on being different and promised to end cronyism amongst insider elites. Even though Dean French, his longtime ally and chief of staff, resigned the day before for giving a 26-year-old friend of his son's a plum job in New York, Ford still threw jabs at opponents during Ford Fest on Saturday.
A select few who they just can't stand that we're taking their hands out of the cookie jar. We're taking their hands out of your pockets.
Patronage appointments are common. All governments award them. But they run afoul of public approval when the appointee is clearly unqualified.
Every government will appoint people that are friendly to their brand. That is common practice in government. When is the line? Where is the line?
Mm-hmm. I think it is fair to say that, again, that you can appoint people that reflect your government's mandate and mission. But these are public appointments. And I think the people of Ontario have a right to expect better of their government, that governments will be appointing people because they're actually suited to the roles and not because their children played lacrosse with your children.
Dismally low polls, booing directed towards the premier, a cabinet shuffle, and now this scandal. Morale feels low within the Ford government. Everyone was hoping things would settle down over the summer and the reset would take hold. One last note for now on Dean French. He surprised many by returning to Queen's Park on Monday. People weren't happy to see him. I'm told his security pass has now been taken away.